So last class we have discussed the theories of overvoltage, and the last topic in electrochemistry is polarography. And it is an actually it is an application of overvoltage and polarization. In this polarography, an electrolyte or a conducting substance or solution is electrolyzed, and we plot a current voltage graph. And this from this current voltage graph we can conclude what is in the solution and how much it is present, the concentration of the conducting material present in the solution. And this polarography is based on the electrolysis of a minute fraction of solution using a cell which is a which is consists of a polarizable micro electrode, that is electrode whose potential changes from its reversible value. Polarizable micro electrode, we know that what is polarization and what is a polarizable electrode. And micro electrode cell consists of a polarizable micro electrode such as dropping mercury electrode and a non-polarizable current-carrying electrode. And that is an electrode whose potential does not change from its reversible value, such as Calomel electrode, or sometimes this mercury at the bottom of the electrode itself can act as this reversible electrode, a large surface area electrode. That is usually so. One is a micro electrode such as dropping mercury electrode and a non-polarizable large electrode like Calomel electrode or mercury at the bottom, collected at the bottom of the of this vessel, of this container, is can also be act as an electrode. And the data obtained by measuring the current as a function of applied voltage from the current voltage curve, information about the nature and concentration of substances may be obtained. The value of current flowing through the cell at any applied voltage is measured with the help of an instrument known as polarograph. The instrument is called polarograph, and these curves obtained are called polarograms. And this is the instrument used for this study. And that is polar. Here we have one micro electrode, a dropping mercury electrode in the top of this of this figure. We have a mercury tank to which one of the platinum electrodes is immersed, which act as a negative terminal of this electrolysis. And here a capillary tube is attached, and through this drops of mercury falls out. And here we are supplying a nitrogen atmosphere to bubble. Nitrogen is bubbled in order to avoid the presence of oxygen. And then the mercury collected at the bottom itself can act as the positive electrode. Positive terminal is connected to this, and a voltmeter is attached here. And a galvanometer and ammeter is ammeter is attached to near the battery, and we have and potential difference can be adjusted using this setup. And so we are plotting potential difference against the current developed. So we are taking a test solution containing 10^-3 to 10^-4 molar concentration of the reducible species. Very small amount of reducible species is required for conducting this experiment, and about 1 molar concentration of suitable supporting electrolyte. The function of supporting electrolyte is a must in polarogram, and this function of supporting electrolyte is to carry current through the solution. Since this actual electrolyte is of very low concentration, the supporting electrolyte helps to carry current, or it will maintain a constant current flow through the solution. And the electrolyte is taken in the cell and is deaerated by passing nitrogen or hydrogen. The dropping mercury cathode, in which mercury drops, grow steadily at the tip of a capillary, which is having 0.05 mm diameter. And these mercury drops are falling at a rate of 20 to 30 drops per minute. And each drop will remain at 2 to 3 seconds at cathode. When the drops fall, next drop takes the place of that drop. A pool of mercury at the bottom of the cell can serve as a reference electrode. Because of its large area, it is negligibly polarizable. And a coulombic electrode can also act as anode. And the cathode and the anode are joined respectively to negative and positive poles of battery. Applied voltage can be varied by adjusting sliding contact D along potentiometer wire EF. Current strength is measured by a sensitive galvanometer. And what are the advantages of dropping mercury electrode? The advantages are its surface area is reproducible in each experiment, and each successive drop presents a new clear surface. That is, impurities are removed. Average current measured is certainly reproducible from drop to drop, and the surface area of drop can be calculated from the weight of drops. And another advantage is that mercury forms amalgams with most of the metals. So it has an affinity for these metals, and so the reduction potentials of these metals are considerably lowered in mercury electrodes. Working. When the external EMF is applied, at all positively charged ions will be attached to the dropping mercury cathode by an electrical force, which results from the gradient formed at surface of electrode. When the applied voltage is increased, current is noted. Current, we are plotting applied voltage against current, that is at a point there is a steady current increase in small increase in current with applied voltage in the solution, which is due to the presence of this supporting electrolyte. At D, which is the decomposition potential of the metal in the electrolytic substance we have taken. After this, at point D, there is a steady increase in current. That is, current carried by supporting electrolyte and impurities are responsible for the small increase in current till D. After D, there is a steady increase in current with potential. At point potential of the electrode become equal to decomposition potential, the current density increases along DC. Onwards, there will be no appreciable change in current with increased applied voltage. And this current corresponding to CD is called limiting current. The difference between residual current and limiting current is called diffusion current. The residual current is at point D and limiting current at point C. And the difference between these two is called diffusion current. And the current due to reduction of ions at dropping mercury electrode is called, and we know that it is due to the reduction of ions in dropping mercury electrode. And this current will be directly proportional to the concentration of the reducible materials. Quantitative estimation is based on the measurement of height of polarograph wave. This is only a qualitative observation. For quantitative estimations, we measure the height of the polarograph weight of wave. The height of the wave is directly proportional to the concentration of ions reduced at cathode, and Cx by C standard is equal to Hx X standard, and Cx is the concentration of unknown solution, C standard is the concentration of standard solution, Hx height of polarographic wave of unknown, and Hx standard is the height of polarographic wave of standard. And we have a standard and we have values for that standard. This equation for polarographic diffusion current it is called hypovic equation. I diffusion is equal to 607 n d half c m 2 by 3 plus 1 by 16. I is the average diffusion current, n number of Faradays required per mole, d diffusion coefficient per centimeter square per second, c is the concentration of in millimoles per liter, m rate of flow of mercury, and t is drop time in seconds. It is observed that diffusion current is proportional to concentration of electroactive material. Diffusion current that we have discussed, halfway potential. Next, it is the potential corresponding to the midpoint of the polarographic curve, that is half wave potential. At midpoint of this wave, the mercury drop contains equal amounts of oxidizable and reducible species. So it is clearly the standard potential of redox system. Halfway potential is independent of the concentration because oxidized reduced potential depends only on the ratio of oxidized and reduced state, and this must be unity at the middle of the current potential wave. And the halfway potential is thus a characteristic property of an ion. Halfway potential measurement is used for qualitative analysis of metal ions and for finding the standard E0 values of redox systems. Then applications of polarography. It is an analytical tool and widely used for trees and for measuring the electrode potentials, for studying the electrode reactions, or for studying other reactions involving electron transfer. That is, first is involving in qualitative analysis. Since halfway potential is characteristics of a substance undergoing reduction at dropping mercury electrode, the E half can be used to identify the substance which is present in the electrolytic solution. In quantitative analysis, according to hypovic equation, diffusion current is proportional to the concentration of reducible species. The concentration of reducible species can be calculated from observed diffusion current. The advantage is that the concentration of species is 10 raised to minus 3 to 10 raised to minus 4. This is a very small quantity, so we can calculate the concentrations or determine the concentrations of very dilute solutions of the electrolyte. Dissolved oxygen is aqueous and organic solvents can be determined by polarographic analysis. Oxygen dissolved in aqueous solution shows distinct cathodic waves. That is, polarographic waves obtained from reduction of species at dropping mercury electrode is called cathodic waves, and from oxidation are called anodic waves. They are otherwise called oxygen waves, are obtained from reduction of oxygen to hydrogen peroxide, the other from reduction of hydrogen peroxide to water. But both these waves are almost same height, and hence dissolved oxygen can be determined from this graph by comparing it with another standard value. And organic compounds which are reduced at dropping mercury electrode includes those containing carbon CO group, CC, CX bonds, NO bond, ISO group, etc. The reductions are generally irreversible, but the diffusion current is usually proportional to concentration. Their solutions for analysis may be prepared in organic solvents. So organic compounds can be also be reduced at the dropping mercury electrode, and we can find out the concentrations and nature of the material, organic material, using this dropping mercury electrode. Polarography can be used for determination of diffusion coefficient of reducible species using hypovic equation. It is used for the determination of stability constants of metal ion complexes. Can find out the stability constants. The components of a mixture of various elements can be determined by polarography. That's a very important method to find out the metals present in a solution of, in a mixture of metals. using polarography, that is, we you have to analyze in your practical classes. You have to analyze four cations from your solution. Four cations from the solution mixture you have provided, and four components of mixture of various element can be determined by polarography. Series of reducible substances can be estimated in one solution. Since half-way potential is characteristic of a particular metal, half-way potential at each diffusion current, the half each curve of polarography, the halfway potential gives an indication about the metal present in the solution. Polarographic analysis is used for the determination of anions such as bromate, vanadate, dichromate, provided the central ion has two or more oxidation states. We can use this method to find out the determination of anions also, not only cations. That's all about the polarography. Thank you.